Well,
Yeah.
we are about to be. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, we are live. How we all doing tonight? Prince Manic, you are indeed first. Hello, to you and hello, Kami. Nice to see you all today on this the Honored Ones podcast member stream, and we already got some members emotes. Yes, you chose Miwa for some reason.
Yes, sir. Yes,
More
sir.
power to you.
W decision, W decision. All right.
See,
But
somebody's
what's
using
up, guys?
Yuji. Thank you, Spirit. Appreciate you. See, this is what I want to see, all right? So let's.
Yuji cool. Yuji cool. Like he like if Miwa Megumi tier 1,
Oh my God.
Kashumo tier 2, then Yuji can get tier 3. Then we can put like Yuta might be with Yuji in tier 3. Gojo can be like in tier 4. Yeah, we can put him in and we can put him in tier 4. I'll allow him to be in tier 4. That
So,
makes sense.
if you guys don't mind a small little tangent before we really get into the meat of today's episode, which was a good one, of course, duh, Mappa killed it, newsflash, right? I do want to just like give a shout out to Baki. This the series, the energy, the
Have you been
franchise
seeing the
I
trends?
have, and I just
Oh
decided,
my God,
bro,
bro.
I just decided to bite the bullet and I watched the new season today. I
Did you?
forgot how much I loved Baki, man. Like, the episode, or I guess the chapter-to-chapter experience, is so good. It's so good. And I, for the longest time, for like as long as I've been like into Baki, I couldn't figure out how to like describe the experience of like being invested in Baki's ridiculous story.
Yeah.
But it's so earnest in its like outlandishness that it doesn't want you to fall into the trap of thinking it's like out of this world, right? Like it doesn't want you to think, oh, this is too ridiculous to follow, right? No. If you ever have that moment, right? Like if a character is like, oh, wait, let me just turn my bones into jelly, the narrator will like sprint to that moment that you have that thought, right? Like at Mach 10. And he'll be like, no, see, it's a metaphorical, like fluid jelly that he's talking about. See, back in ancient Mesopotamia. And then he'll go into like that whole spiel.
Yeah.
It's
They
like,
will,
yeah.
bro. Will, Jesus, the ancient Egyptians knew that you can. It's like Jesus Christ, but you made this up. You
Yeah,
were a
but
liar.
also,
This isn't
bro,
real.
like I wasn't like attacking. Like I'm okay if it's just like him turning into jelly. Like it's all right, bro.
It's fine. Like it's not illegal to have some sort of like, exaggeration in your fictional manga, But it's like, no, this is what I genuinely appreciate, right? Like seriously like is the like you said that like the willingness to say the most dumb, idiotic, ridiculous bullshit, but really really say it with its chest, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like I think an example of this, right? An example of like the opposite effect is like the MCU, right? And MCU kind of gets like hate, like Spider-Man, what kind of name is that? Laugh track, laugh track, laugh track. Like I don't really mind that sort of humor, but I do know that a lot of people kind of want comic book or like those like adaptation type movies to really lean into the silliness of it, right? Really like revel in the camp. Baki does,
It
but
does.
like it's not just in moments, that's Baki. Like, bro will walk behind somebody into a military
And be
facility
dead
to
serious,
see
yeah.
a prehistoric human being who fought Tyrannosaurus
And
Rexes,
won.
who can also transform into his real T-Rex hunt. Like, bro, and all of that is serious as hell. Like,
It's dead
it's
serious.
just said with a
Yeah.
straight face.
And the thing is, right? Like, not if it's not the narrator, it's one of the characters' inner monologues. They would rather die than let you think this wasn't the result of like meticulous hard work and training. Like seriously. Like, dude, Retsu is like, if I match my pattern of breathing exactly to the tune of his while walking at like his specific pace, I'm able to just sort of blend behind. Like, dude, you can just have superpowers at that point. Like, it's all right. It's fine.
Like, okay, Katsumi's whole thing, right? I think that's his name.
Yeah, the whip. Oh my
Bro.
God. Oh my God.
First of all, crazy first thing to mention from him.
Stop.
I'm just gonna say that's nuts. Cause I was gonna go with the speed of sound punch, but like
That was like his. He brought a
bro said the
whip
whip.
to
Bro said the
demonstrate.
whip.
He.
The
Oh
whip.
my
The
God.
whip. The whip. Bro, the whip with the coolest part. Listen, I'm gonna leave it. I'm gonna leave it, right? We not even like 10 minutes in here, so I'm gonna leave it. But I will say this.
Appreciate the self-control.
Bro, bro said he, okay, he was like, because the thing is, he had the doubt that the audience had. The, no, this is impossible. That's ridiculous, right? And he's like, wait, every being in the wild does this. The giraffe wanted to get food at the top of the tree, so it grew its neck. I'm like, huh? He's like, the elephant grew the trunk, the tiger its stripes. And then he said, and compared to that, humans' evolution is so minuscule. And then he's just God. I'll just divide my bones like this, or this.
Dude, the thing with the joints where he was like, wait, I have like 28 joints on my spine. That'll give me even more like speed to transcend the sound barrier.
Bro, I'm like, what are you doing? You're trying to justify you splitting your joints into hundredths because a giraffe has a long neck. And you mean it.
You mean it. And it's not just that you mean it. You need me to know that. It's imperative for you that, like, I see what you're doing, and I don't think, oh, this guy's got superpowers. He's like, no, you could do this, too, if you just imagine what I imagine.
And it's just truly imagination. And I'm like, what am I watching right now? I'm going to be real with you. Watching Baki, quote-unquote, out-of-context clips, although I have the context because I've seen everything. It's such a surreal experience, even as someone who's seen it all.
Yep.
I can only imagine and somewhat envy what someone who has no idea about Baki really sees when they look at this, man.
Because, like, what I think Baki out-of-context clips mislead people into thinking is that it's a very, like, ridiculous series. Like, it is, right? But, like, when you actually get into the series, right? Like get into the entire series, story, characters, etc. Like, you're really diving in with, like you would any other series. It takes itself so seriously, but it doesn't present it that way. And it is the funniest contrast in the world, because I legitimately was moved to tears by the conversation Baki had with what's that guy's name with the glasses about his mother. You know what I'm talking about, where he was like, I'm trying to repay my mother's love, I'm not trying to avenge
her. Pranayama? Like, are you talking,
it's a skinny old dude.
At the cafe. The, like, Aikido. Yeah. No, wait, hold on. Yeah, okay, got you. I know what you're talking about.
But, like, dude, I was, like, moved by that conversation where he was like, I'm not trying to avenge my mom's death by beating Yujiro. Like, I'm trying to repay her love for standing up to the strongest guy in the world. I'm like, why?
Listen, bro. Like, are some moments in Baki, right, that are just – they're some of your favorite anime's hardest lines, bro.
Yep.
Someone – who works hard can never be someone who's having fun. And it's just in reference to Baki always existing in combat, right? And I'm just like, what are we doing here? This is Baki. This is the series where, like, you have,
Jack and Piccolo got into a fighting match. Like, what are we doing? Dude, the demon brain thing.
The demon brain. He said, no, bro. What? And it's serious, and it's given an explanation. It's a physiological change that really exists, bro. And it's not a metaphor. It's not a joke. It's
literal.
It's
like,
just bro.
Like, it's so fucking funny. Like, in the same episode, right at the end, right, Baki is having like a shadow training boxing thing in his basement, right, and he's imagining Yujiro. He launches himself into a wall so loudly, Japan thinks it's an earthquake. Why? Yeah, who is this for?
Bro, do you remember when Baki put himself through 4,000 years worth of training, like, with Chinese martial arts?
Oh, God.
Like, he said, no, I've actually trained just as long as you. What? Like, I now... What?
Oh, shut up. Like,
what are you talking about? What is going on here, right? Like, and you try to explain it. You really do try. You give it your all. You really like, is real. This is the power of imagination.
But it's like, bro, I wasn't doubting you. Like, where are you? Who is telling you that I'm, like, not buying it, right? Like, who is telling you that, like, this is taking me out of this series, right? Let me have a word with them, please. Because if they're motivating you to go this hard every single episode, every single chapter, they simply need to be sued at that point for slander.
Bro, have you seen that, like, the edited panel, like, Retsu just being, like, a head? I've seen so many people who have not seen Baki be like, what? Because the thing is...
It's in character for the show,
It's so possible. That could be Baki. It is so in line with the context, with the general vibe of the series, that Retsu actually only losing his leg is the weirder thing.
Yeah, dude.
It's like, huh, that was actually pretty tame.
And then he just, like, takes up boxing, and I was like, bro, a golden stand version of yourself told you to embrace martial arts to the bitter end and to be, like, the truest awakened form of yourself.
Oh, Jesus.
And you're like, nah, bro, this boxing shit is where it's at.
And bro just actually genuinely boxes.
Yep.
Like, why? Because. Like, literally because.
Bro, they called him, like, the hero of Chinese martial arts. And he was like, this boxing shit, bro?
Yeah, it's boxing kind of real, bro. Boxing kind of fun. Listen, I think. Oh, the pissing clip.
Oh,
bro,
my
in
God.
Prison.
There's so many of them.
Oh, my. The way they try to explain that as a real counter is actually. Like, okay, waffling and yapping doesn't begin to describe what Baki does sometimes,
yeah.
Man.
But
like it's actually impressive.
Like, I would not be surprised if the Baki narrator was paid per word. Because bro is the king of yapping. Like he is the Yapatron 9000. He is the yip yap yap. Like bro is...
You think JJK needs a narrator? Mm. Baki would be... incoherent without bro. Somebody telling you the entire time that the only reason this is possible is because one baby in a cave 1 billion years ago came up with the ability to slap. It's like,
dude, the entire pickle arc would have literally been just scribbles on paper without that narrator. Like, he was Pickle's character, like the narrator was Pickle to some degree, right? His innermost thoughts, feelings, experiences, all the narrator.
He got bro, the slap. The explanation for slapping is the strongest martial art technique ever. No matter what, it hurts the largest organ of the body. They're trying to convince me that slapping is officially the highest form of martial arts. Along with becoming a cockroach,
but,
of course,
yeah,
to dash at super speed.
But the
speed.
Problem is, why is it working? Why?
You drew. I simply dispersed all of the pain across my body evenly in order to not scream. What?
Dude, there's this. Speaking of Yujiro, he's like the most egregious example because, like, bro, there's this bit, right? It was the most like innocuous Yujiro moment I can think of, but for some reason, it just like is the first thing I think about when it comes to him. Over time, Yujiro was able to adapt to every form of weapon and animal on the planet to the point where he gained this new ability to instantly sense and detect the weaknesses of every living organism.
Yeah, bro, such bullshit. He is more precise vision than any medical equipment on the planet.
No, they said a precisely tuned MRI machine. He can cancer cells that are like, what?
I'm like, why can he do this? Why?
Come on, you never been to a boxing gym? That's like day one stuff.
Bro, regardless, this man is on his guard. Even if lightning was to strike, he'd be able to respond to it on time.
Why?
What?
Bro.
Why? Like, why is bro, he's not, is he getting attacked by lightning?
Like, did he have smoke with Zeus? And like,
yeah, bro. Why? And Zeus obviously lost.
Right? Fucking hell. Sleeping Ninja, thank you for the 14. What's more ridiculous, Baki or JoJo? I haven't watched JoJo, but like
I'm not the most aware JoJo's. Well, I'm not gonna call myself a JoJo's fan. That's nuts, right? But I've seen parts 1 through 5 of JoJo's, and from my remember, there's nothing as crazy as like Baki's most insane moments. It's different, bro, because JoJo's takes itself more seriously in general. There's some bullshit, don't get me wrong. It's not called JoJo's Bizarre Adventure for no reason.
Right.
But, like, Baki, there's another level with Baki. You know what I mean?
Like,
the Musashi swordless style. Like, bro,
like,
No, bro, you knew you were cut.
Yeah. I think, huh? Like, part of the reading experience with Baki that, like, takes over the edge for me is, like, it despises any... like thought that its premise is like ridiculous, right?
Third.
Yeah, yep. Like it is like, what are you talking about, dude? This is just a normal confrontation between a father and son. Like you're the weird one for thinking like we're the bizarre one.
Itagaki, I think, is the author of Baki. Definitely thinks this is just a sports manga.
My favorite line, the most like iconic line for me in Baki, is every single time Baki himself is asked about like why he does what he does, he's just like, I don't know what you're talking about, dude. This is just a simple disagreement between a father and son. I'm like, no, it's not. What are you talking about?
Oh my god. Yeah.
Dude, that line drives me fucking crazy. Like, what are you doing, bro? He's just like, no, I want to beat up my dad, but he just so happens to be the strongest guy in the world. And means that. Like, he means it.
It's unfortunate that he is, right? But that's all it is. Like, yeah. Come on now.
And I was ill, you know? I got to do what I got to do. But in the same breath, like, and I got to officially give Baki entry into, like, my top 100 favorite characters of all time. Like, Baki himself. Because, like, this dude is simultaneously the chillest, most reasonable guy in his show, while simultaneously being, I don't know how else to describe it, but like cursed by being a Hanma.
I'm gonna, like, be real with you. Baki can range from having some of the coolest shit to like some of the most like, bro, getting peed on
is insane.
By like, I'm like, listen, bro, I know you're gonna beat his ass later. It doesn't matter.
Like,
listen, bro.
It's,
come on now,
bro. Because he was like, you know, a lesser person would try to beat him through some other tricks. Me, I need to beat him in a strength contest. No, yeah. You don't.
And like, he's like, why? I'm like, bro, you know martial arts. He's like, no, you're the strongest man in America, right? I'm going to fight you on your terms.
And it's like, Baki, you won. Congrats. Did you need to go to prison? Like, let's call a spade a spade here, right?
He can leave anytime he wants, bro. You could have asked him to come meet you. Nah. No,
I got to do the full experience. And like, he's so reasonable about it. Like he'll explain it in the most calm, rational, like you'll think, oh wait, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah, that makes sense. And they're like, no, it doesn't.
Yeah. It's like after you like get away from Baki speaking, you're like, wait, the fuck did he just say?
He's just chill. So like the bullshit he says does not really register. One of the funniest things ever, right? So you know when Yujiro's fighting that old guy, I do not remember his name, like the master of Chinese martial arts or whatever, right? And it's like the pinnacle of his thing is just like going limp so he doesn't take damage. You see that kind of thing like, oh, you twisted your body to negate. You see that in Battle Shonen all the time, blah, 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 right? But Yujiro's sort of like counter to that being, I'm going to pull hair out of your head, make you flinch for a second, and then just fucking hit you. I'm like, that is simultaneously the smartest and
dumbest
thing I've ever even been introduced to.
Dude, Yujiro going on that whole spiel about true speed is something the opponent can't perceive until it's too late, no matter how slow it is. And then he's just like, but, you know, I'm still fucking fast.
Yeah. Oh, that was funny as shit with the kicking.
Yeah.
With the kicking. That was funny as hell. There's that. The fucking, bro, there's like, do you see how easily we're rattling off just the most absurd bullshit?
Like, bro, I would give $200 to anybody who could accurately power scale somebody like Yujiro. Like,
I'm gonna be real with you, right? I'm gonna be real with you. There are videos that maybe they'll see the light of day, right? I am pretty convinced that if you drop Yujiro and JJK, seriously, unironically, not a meme, not a joke, the only person who survives is Gojo, maybe.
Maybe.
I don't know if Yujiro would be able to surpass the Limitless, but he, you know, due to like his overwhelming, you know, fucking, I don't know, testosterone plus the Hanma blood would allow him to bypass it's it like a dope, like whatever, bro, right?
Is like Yujiro unironically has better adaptability feats than Maharaga. Like, that's so weird.
Like, seriously.
Why?
Bro, he keeps it. It's easy. Like, bro, the narrator might pull some bullshit like the entire world is Yujiro's domain. Man. And then he just fucking hits him. Like, I'm going to be seriously like looking you guys in your eyes. And I'd say if I had to bet my life, right, on Yujiro or Sukuna winning in a fight right now, I promise you I'd put it all on Yujiro. And I swear, I promise you guys that.
Yeah.
Like, literally, Yujiro Sukuna. Yujiro, what are we doing? I promise you, I'm living. I'm walking out of there and I'm alive. No question.
Bro, Yujiro scaling is the funniest thing in the world because he is canonically immune to every nation's like military forces, including nuclear weapons. Yeah. The narrator, God bless him. He acts like, he will get fired if he does not mention that nuclear weapons are part of that arrangement, right? Like, he is
like it's not a political thing. It's not that he can't just use it on, like, it's like, doesn't matter if they shoot it, right?
He has, like, an answer for
it. And it doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter, bro.
Right. But, like, at the same time, you'll see his skin stretched, like, getting through glass, and you're like,
yeah.
How? What? Like, what?
No, he just let it, though. He just let it, though. Okay. That's the thing. He just let it. And the crazy thing is, too, bro, it's just like, and then there'll be like typical, like, Baki's jab moved faster than the speed of light. And, you know, sometimes in Battle Shonen that can be an exaggeration, mm-hmm. right? But I don't think so for Baki. I deadass think.
Yeah, I think Yujiro would do it.
If you turned on a flashlight and Baki threw out a jab, his jab would reach you faster than the flashlight. Like, faster than the photon. Like, bro, it's actually ridiculous. Actually, it's...
Like, the crazy thing is, right, even if you wanted to, like, get into a fight with Yujiro, right, you shouldn't, ever, right, he's one of those characters, no. right, you wouldn't even want to be in the same vicinity as him, like, people, the narrator was just, dude, he was describing Yujiro walking down the street, it was an entire scene dedicated to Yujiro just going on a walk, it wasn't even, like, a huge plot thing, it was just Yujiro going on a walk, and the narrator was, like, every single person who, like, looked at upon Yujiro stopped instantly in their tracks because the survival cells in their body knew that he was more dangerous before their brains did, and they all, like, stopped, like, a deer who came face to face with a hungry lion or something, and I'm like, bro, he is just going on a walk, why? Like, just,
yeah.
Bro, how much ridiculous. Is your rent? What are we doing here?
Yujiro has so much testosterone that every other being on the planet is a woman. What? I don't think that's how that works, but okay. Fair enough. You said it with confidence, so you have to be right. You know what I mean? Like, the utmost bravado.
All Hanma offspring, if they start out as women, will end up as men just because they have Hanma blood.
It's like, bro, what are we doing? What's going on here? What's going on here, bro? It's actually ridiculous. But yeah, that's a Baki rant.
Yeah.
That's a Baki rant.
Yeah, it's just been like on the top of my mind because, like, man, it's not just the recency bias, but, like, I gotta give Baki, like, formal it's officially
Baki is something.
It's officially Baki's entered my top 10.
I'm gonna be real with you. Like, listen, I will say this. Baki is one of the few series I will say if you refuse to read it or watch it, because, like, I kinda get it.
Yeah.
It's super long, first of all, and it's just, like, fucking ridiculous. I genuinely implore you to just go watch out of context clips.
Yeah.
Like, because it's just so fun. Because it's like a genuinely fun experience, and you can, it's not much more coherent for you guys than it is for people who've read it.
Yeah, like, that's the thing. You will be just as shocked when it happens in story as you would out of context. Like, the only thing that you get from doing it, like, in context is just, like, the storyline of Baki, I guess.
Yeah, you know the characters and shit like that.
But, like, I'll be real. You know, like, 20% of the characters in Baki have, like, character arcs to them. And 80% of the time you see them, they're in the ring.
Yep. I mean, duh. Like, bro, yeah, like, listen. We are seeing the same thing. When Baki melts into a puddle of water, reforms, and does the cockroach dash, that's just the thing.
Yeah. Like, there's no foreshadowing for that, right? It's not like... Oh, you know, Baki turns on his faucet in the morning. It's foreshadowing him turning into water. That's not how it works, right? It could.
He looks at a cockroach on the ground, says, huh, why does it have nothing inside of it, right? It's just liquid. Wait, what if I'm just liquid? What if I just ignored my organs? Then I'd be able to reach top speed. What? What's going on here? 2 + 2, what? You got 2 + 2 equals I can beat Yujiro? Okay, fine. I guess so.
Bro, like, Baki will drop, down 70 stories twice, like, in a row, like, look like he's about to die, and then just be like, you know what? No, I'm not a bitch. And he'll just suddenly be fine.
Yeah. He's like, I'm all right. BR versus 3-month-old Yujiro. Why would you ever do that to me? I'm going to be real with you. I'm going to be real with you, right? I think I'd rather fight. Okay. I'd rather fight prime Mike Tyson, right, than one-year-old Yujiro. So I'm so serious. Because here's the thing. Let's say I do beat Yujiro somehow, right? Mm. I barely come out with my life, but I heal like a mech stronger. Once he's like 5, maybe 10, if we want to be generous, he's going to find me.
He's not going to forget your name.
Yeah. He's going to get me back.
Yeah.
Right? And even I could get plastic surgery. I could legally change my name. He's going to sense my cells.
Yeah.
He's going to sense that these are the only cells in the world that have ever beat Yujiro or some bullshit like that, man. It's just ridiculous.
Like, Yujiro would unironically just, like, put his finger up to, like, everybody he touches who even sort of looks like you, and he's going to be like, my cells didn't tingle. You're not the guy. And just keep it pushing until he finds you.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah. No.
Would you rather fight 10,000 creams versus 16-year-old Yujiro? The 10,000 creams seems like an easier fight, bro. I'm not going to lie to you.
Like, easily, bro. I'm going to be real with you. You could give me a nuclear bomb versus Yujiro and one sledgehammer versus the creams army, and I know which one I'm taking, right? Bro, I'm sorry, buddy, but...
What I find...
Listen.
Like, bro, yeah. Going back to, like, Yujiro, like, JJK scaling, and I guess this will be our segue, right? Mm. If you can, you know that like meme that's like, no powers, who wins this anime gauntlet thing?
Mm-hmm.
Would you put any, like, not even just Yujiro, any Baki character in there and assume they'd be depowered? Or like, do you think that there is a power system to be taken away?
The only thing you could say is imagination, and no. I would say that's just how they're built.
Yeah.
Like, that's just, no powers is just... It's just them. They're the Baki versus no powers. You know what I mean?
That is just how they exist. Yeah.
And like, I'm gonna be real. I'd put JJK versus the Baki verse with powers. Like I wouldn't take. I'm not doing that to them, right?
Oh,
no. Keep your curse energy. Keep your technique. Keep your domains.
Yeah.
Like, Yujiro's gonna be like, sure, the attack spawned on top of me, but I decided to move out of the way after that. And it's like, all right, bro, whatever.
Yeah.
What are we doing here?
I think somebody like Kenjaku, dude. Keep your domain up.
You'd be
like,
fascinated.
Keep it
up. I'm going to be real. I think that would be the thing that surpasses all other creation. That's what he's looking for.
Fucking Hanma just blood.
Yujiro Hanma. But yeah. I guess just switching from the Baki talk into the episode. Unfortunately for me, I won't be able to talk as passionately about the episode as Baki, weirdly enough. Because I don't know about you, just a general sort of like overview of my thoughts and then we can get into it. Mm. This episode was pretty like meh. Like, it's not a bad episode by any means.
Yeah.
It was set up. I think even visually too, it was like pretty regular. Yeah. I'll say like, and this isn't like, I'm not upset about how it came out. I'm not really like, oh my God, this is so garbage. But
yeah, I think it's just the
events from the story for sure. And I will say it's somewhat hard to look at like what I consider to be some of the best pieces of animation I've seen in like recent history, like Gojo versus Toji, Geto versus Toji, like Mechamaru versus Mahito, and then we go into like Yujiro versus the Grasshopper being like a pretty solid like 7.5 in terms of like animation quality. Mm-hmm. It's not that it on its own is bad, it's just almost jarring. It's like, holy shit.
Yeah. I will say the Yuji versus Grasshopper Curse Spirit was funny. And I think it was meant to be, right? Like the jokes landed like really well for me. You know, clever people don't usually say that, and the cockroach and the grasshopper spirit being like, you know, like, oh.
Yeah. What? Are you serious?
Yeah. Huh. You know, this was, you know what this episode was really good for? You know that meme that's like JJK villains versus JJK heroes. And it's like the heroes looking demented or whatever, and like the villains like looking playful. That was this episode, dude. Jogo, Geto, and like the other disaster curses were literally in a playground blowing bubbles, talking about their plan.
Yeah.
Dude, Yuji looked more like a villain.
Hanami and Mahito were just having the time of their life, bro. They were just galloping. I'm not gonna lie, Mahito probably killed everybody there. Yeah. If I just had to guess, right? Yeah, no, but like
he had fun.
They had fun.
Yeah.
They had fun.
The kids were playing. The sun was shining. Bro, Yuji came out of the darkness, emerging with like fists and like, blood. Like, what are we doing?
Where is the patch face curse? Right? I'm not with the bullshit. I'm here to get some revenge. I don't like that guy.
Gojo took off the blindfold, and I was like, "Whoa! I didn't do anything."
Yeah. I will say, I think the like the B5F sequence was probably like back up to par visually with everything else we've seen.
Oh, that was.
I think. the piercing blood was really not the piercing blood, but like the slicing exorcism shows those like blood makers look really cool.
The one thing that I didn't like about it is that it originated from his little line on his nose, but it didn't like, it wasn't like blood. It didn't the line didn't morph into blood. Like blood came out of it as if it was like an opening. I want it to be like a seamless, you know the thing I'm talking about with Choso, like.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about. Like where like the line is the like is it the continues blood, from that is what you wanted basically. Yeah, that makes sense. I get you. I get you.
Yeah, I was gonna say like it was very cool just to see like how they described the stakes or like the premise of what's going on in Shibuya with the little graph and everything. Because in the manga, it was good, but I think Gege gets a little he assumes a lot of the audience or like of the reader, and it's fine, right? He can do that. It's worked out for the most part. That's how the series exists, like it does. But every once in a while, it'll exist with this like. It's good that they added a little bit more breathing room to your explanation.
I agree. Yep.
So in Yuji 14, Yuji no cursed energy versus Mei no cursed energy, but has an axe. Yuji.
Mei's getting bullied.
Yeah. Like Yuji without cursed energy.
Physical human.
Like, Yuji without cursed energy was like a monster already. Crazy how beginning of Shibuya Yuji wanted to run hands with Mahito, bro, was about to get packed up. You know what's funny?
Yeah, that would not have ended well. But yeah.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's so amusing to me that Yuji's like come so far already at this point Shibuya, where he's like he went from like being not being able to summon any cursed energy, you know, crying about like, oh, I might have made a mistake, right, with the finger bearer, to like,
yeah,
where is Mahito?
Yeah,
nice little
I agree hunting him down and stuff. I'm like, I will say this. So I've seen a lot of people, I forgot, Yuji says, I'll never lose again. He says that twice. He says that immediately after Mahito, like, kicks his ass. When it kicks his ass, like, immediately after he fails to go Mahito, basically, before he, like, before the goodwill arc, he's like, I'm done losing, right? I'm done with that bullshit. Well, that wasn't true, right? and then he says it again, like, I won't lose to anything again. And then obviously Choso caves his chest cavity in, right? And then Tsukuna makes sure that maybe he won't lose much, but dozens and dozens and dozens. But I will say one thing. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are like noting this as like a throwaway episode or like a relatively like lower quality thing, all things concerned. Like, I will say personally, I was hoping the Yuji versus Grasshopper fight kind of cooked a bit more, but in the grand scheme of things, right, with how much Shibuya is gonna have, for whatever reason you want to give it, I'm not mad at like this episode in particular with this content being like regular. Like, that's perfectly fine to me.
I'm like, save the money. If you're saving the money here to spend it on a more special event down the line, go for it, you know. It's just economical. Like, if they're not going hard on this episode to go harder on like the next two episodes, I get it.
Yeah, we can conserve ourselves on the next two episodes too. I'm gonna be real. We'll save it. Get that guy out of the way with the little budget.
Yeah.
But man. Agreeing is crazy, bro. I'm looking forward to it. We about to see some. Listen, I'm excited for next episode. I'll put it like that. I think they're definitely going to cook.
You know, there's this, the trend has continued into this week. Ever since this arc started, I think a week or two ago, the level of, like, dread. I know everything that's going to happen, right? But a part of me is like, what if it doesn't, though? Like, what if it doesn't?
What if what doesn't?
Like, what if everything that's going to happen that we know is going to happen doesn't happen, right? What if they just...
In the next episode specifically?
Yeah.
Oh. Or like if it's a cliffhanger, you mean?
Yeah, no, I just don't want the events. Yeah, what?
Like how we wanted Mechamaru to not die.
Yeah.
Nah, bro, get him out of here. I'm gonna be real with you. Like, I'm actively waiting for it. Nah, dude, Jesus, I'm dreading.
Cause like, okay, you know how that you know how we were like, oh, you know, seeing Shibuya in action, right? You realize it's like a very active part of a major city. You know, it's so full of life. This shit is probably terrifying, and it looks terrifying, right? MAPPA does a really good job of conveying, like, tonally, environmentally, like how scary all these events are happening, like what they're like. let me tell you, man, a post that character world, I don't know if I'm ready to see that animated.
I'm so excited for that, bro. I'm gonna be real with boots. You because I don't care about them at all. Okay, don't care about them all is kind of nuts.
It is.
Emotionally, I'm not like, oh my god, you're gone. All right, bro, peace.
Me. No, that's
yeah,
me.
I know, that's yeah. You. I'm like, all right, it's time to lock in. It's really time to get active. And like, no, don't get me wrong. I'll be begging and pleading for the plot to change in a little bit. don't misunderstand, right? I will be sniveling and snotting, just hoping to God that he will just make a change. But right now, no thanks. Mm. I think I'm pretty happy with what's about to come up next. Mm. Because it's interesting though. Sort of how quickly things switch, right? Because we're in Shibuya, blah blah blah, but the ball hasn't dropped yet, obviously. And I just kind of find it interesting that like, wow, this one little measly inconsequential event that nobody cared about just really changes the story permanently. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. Dude. Yep.
You know, there's certain parts in MAPPA's execution of this anime that make me like angrier at Gege than I was when I was reading the manga, because you know, we joked about it last episode on Sunday, where we were like, Gege has a lot to answer for, we need to fight him if we ever saw him type shit, right? But I'm telling you, right, if there is like, if they animate the rest of the manga with this level of like gravitas and emotional like resonance the same way they've been doing,
mm-hmm.
I feel like I might just have to fly to Japan and take matters into my own hands. Like,
bro, I didn't even know
I didn't know how badly you hurt me until I saw it like happen in motion.
Yeah, no, I don't disagree. Yuji saying you guys got to stop looking down on humans is raw as hell. Yeah, bro. I'm like, you know what? Yeah. Tell him.
Like in the manga, it was cool, right? It's neat, but it wasn't like raw.
And I'm like, oh, let him know, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, cook.
And then at the same time, I remember like what happens in the next couple episodes. I'm like, let me see how expensive these flights are. I can't believe I let you get away with this like the first time.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I'm. I will say. I understand what you mean in that realm.
I mean, what? Like, I'm kind of that scene for you, dude. Shit, I don't know if I'd be able to hold you back.
You won't be able to. I'll tell you that right now. I'll tell you that for free, buddy. There are a couple of scenes like that, though, that, like, you won't be able to hold me back. You know what I mean? One, some in good ways, right? Mm. Some in, like, Gege, I'll find you. I'll, Shocker! You can't escape me! I'll hunt you to the ends of the earth! Yeah, like, I gotta body you, bro. I gotta body you.
Right, like, I'm putting on the black suit, dude. Like, I'm finding you.
Yeah. Yeah, we gotta start throwing down. That's all it is. I don't know. I think this episode is pretty tame, pretty relaxed, like all things considered. I'm not mad at it at all. I'm gonna be real. MAPPA's been kind of cooking for all this time, so it feels like more of the prelude in more ways than one. Like animation, pretty calm.
Mm.
Narratively, like a lot of build up stuff, yeah. Like that. I'm not mad.
It's weird to call it calm considering like the actual events that happen in the episode.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I wonder what this experience was like for an anime only, because they think, oh my god, shit's going down, right? And I guess we have like the curse, or I guess the benefit, however you look at it, of knowing what's coming. So it's like I'm bracing myself for a bigger impact, or maybe they're doing that subconsciously. I wonder what that's like.
Yeah.
You know what I wish we had? I wish we had, like you know how news stations have reporters that are, like, at the scene? You know?
Yeah.
Like, I wish we had that for, like, the Honored Ones. Like, we had a correspondent who was, like, first-time JJK watcher, like, through the anime.
Yeah. That would be interesting. You would spoil them very quickly. Oh, but, yeah, that would be interesting. Listen, bro, don't make me... You know you would, right? Like, let's not beat around the bush. I'm not saying you wouldn't do it on accident, right? I'm just saying you would. I just don't trust your, like, I'll put it like this. Your talking to thinking ratio is not high enough, right?
It's insane.
You would just blurt. That's a good one. I'm not going to lie to you. But anyways, I think like you would just say something like, I guess if we were to rewind time to a week. Oh, my God, bro. I can't wait for Mechamaru to like to really clutch up right before he dies. Oops, my fault. I spoiled you. Like you would say something very similar to that. I'm going to be real with you. Or just like something along those lines of like, damn, bro. You know, as soon as you see Mechamaru, it's like, ah, rest in peace. You'd say some dumb shit like that. I know it. Not only do I know it, I've seen it. And my algorithm, my research is showing me that, like, yeah, that's just in character, bro. That's just in character.
Well, hey, man, don't tell me the odds.
Well, it's 100%. There is no reality in which you don't do it, right? Now, we've run the numbers on how quickly, and in the most charitable of cases, right, if this person, if they talk as much as we talk, right, interact on Twitter, Discord, that type of stuff, right, I give them 2 weeks, right? I give them 2 weeks, and that's, like, literally we crunch the numbers in the most favorable way to you. They can last 2 weeks without getting spoiled, right? And I mean 2 weeks from knowing you.
Bro.
Like, that just from, yeah.
I don't like spoilers, all right? I'm a spoiler-free kind of guy. All right, I used to block people, you know, in my real life, my real friends, for spoiling stuff, right?
Used to. That's the thing. You're not still like that, bro. You don't got that. Listen, bro, I'd block a family member if they spoiled me on something. You hear me?
You know.
This shit gets serious.
BR. Come on. Just between us.
Yeah,
what up?
Yeah, between us and everybody in chat right now. Yeah, what up?
Yeah, and everybody who's going to listen later. Mm-hmm. I want to talk to you about something. It's sort of related, but not really.
Okay.
Now Sunday, you put out that bounty.
Yeah.
I'm going to need you to cancel that expeditiously, if you don't mind.
Why would I do that?
Come on, man. Come on. Have you been reading the comments under that last podcast?
Nope.
You know what? Never mind. What were we talking about?
Thank you. I got something to do real quick. I was just saying that what I'm going to do this next segment of the episode is me going to actually be reading them out loud since you brought it to my attention. Thank you. You're a really good guy, you know? You're a really good guy in that capacity. You really know how to bring attention to your flaws.
So, Cream says, Live actually... Dude, I didn't even do anything.
Oh, my God.
Here we go.
Though he'd probably never find meaning in minority rights. BR's gaze melted Cream's heart. What?
Oh my God.
What? Oh no. No, 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 no. That's truly fucking insane. Jesus Christ. What? Oh no. So you know... For context, this is a little bit of less known of a reference, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know when Yuki's like telling Geto, like, "Hey, bro, Toji was not normal. It's okay that you lost to him, right?"
Oh my God, I know the one you're talking about. No,
he was truly super racist. Don't be ashamed you lost to him. Yikes, yikes.
You know, hello's chat here. Your talking to thinking ratio is not good. Is actually a very unique one, bro.
I did think that was pretty creative. I'm not going to lie to you. I thought that was pretty creative. Wow.
You know...
Hold on. Someone timestamped and said, "You lost your mind. I'm going to watch this."
You know what's... you know what kills me, though? Like...
What? Civil rights?
Ha, 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 ha. No. The fact that, like... Somebody on Twitter, in reaction to the part Mikey clipped out... Where I was talking about Clap Jaku, you know, that whole meme.
But yeah.
Somebody was like, "Oh, you know what would be a great idea? What was the idea? Like some kind of bingo. Oh, yeah. Like a fucking Honored Ones bingo card." I was thinking about
You talking to me about that, yeah.
So I was thinking, like, obviously, you know, the easy one is Creams has like an understandable human moment that anybody would have, really, and that we shouldn't judge him, right? That's what it would say on that tile, just that tile. Mm-hmm. We can make it fit, right? If we, you know, choose like a fucking 3 font size.
Yeah.
The other one would be BR is mean to creams.
Well, that's easy.
I'd have that take three spaces just for, but you know, whatever.
I mean, that's a free square. You know what I mean? That's like, come on now.
Okay. Cream slander would be a free space in the center. What, bro? What? One of the cards would be Live and Landa backing up BR. Now this one would be like a tricky one. This is how you know somebody won't get the full board, right? But it's happened once. It has never happened. I don't remember it happening. Oh my god, I think I just gaslit myself into thinking it happened. Never mind.
What would it be?
Them supporting me. I do not think that's happened. I think I've gotten one or the other.
There are times where you've been supported in chat.
Yeah, supported, but not like by the whole squad. You know?
But like Live in Landa?
Yeah, right. Like I need like Gojo Meat Rioting would be one of the squares. Or Aizen. Alright, I'm willing to give you guys like that one. I'm not gonna lie to you.
I think a rare one, but like one that could happen is like give me like a Sasuke bingo card, bro. I can talk about Sasuke, but like,
oh, I got I've one. Only done I got one. BR talks about banning people for Megumi slander.
Yeah, you just got to get me going on Megumi. Like, that's not my opening move, but it's not a finisher either, right? That's like a mid tier attack. You know, but yeah.
I know Jujutsu Kaisen is gonna go hard Sunday with both BR and Liv. I'm telling you right now. Liv has been employee of the month for like 7-8 months straight. I am willing to consider giving it to BR for the first time.
Hey, listen, bro.
You're not even gonna ask who's been getting it for like the first like duration of the podcast.
Listen, bro, I'm gonna be real. An employee of the month handed out by you, means less than a random leaf I can find on the ground.
It was me.
So you know you can hand them out, right?
To myself, yes.
You can hand them out.
I think I earned it, you know. But I'm charitable enough.
We don't
enough,
pay you to think, buddy.
I'm charitable enough, you know, like to give Liv her due, right? But like, you know, I'm doing my thing. I think one day, right, if you stop roasting me long enough, you can get it too.
Interesting. Now, chat, would you like to notice who the or what type of person is the only one that hasn't gotten an employee of the month award?
I literally like just said our second longest reigning employee of the month is, from what I have gathered through implication, some kind of minority. All right, so you're welcome, I guess.
Oh, interesting. So like you specify that you hate black people. I get it. Like, I gotcha. So it's up. Not like people. It's not minorities up. In general. It's just black people. Okay. That makes sense. Cool, chat. So we got it. We narrowed it down, right? So he's like, no. Listen, I don't hate everyone. Just you guys. Have you seen a question? This is really relevant to you. Okay. It's a webtoon I know you read, right? Have you seen that like the image, like that, like an image floating around of like that really, really racist, like webtoon, like sort of like interaction or whatever? I'm going to send it to you because I know you read it. I'm just wondering if you read the newest chapter.
I don't know what you're... I've only read like one webtoon and that was Solo Leveling.
Nah, you read this one. I know you did. It's okay. Cream's Core. I'm going to be real with you. It has racism.
Let's see what you're talking
about. I want to see if I can find it. Basically, the gist of it... Nah, actually, that's crazy to say.
Let me see it first before you describe it.
Well, I got to try to find it. I actively did not seek this out because, you know, very racist. let me see if I can.
It's not even that. Yeah. Just like show me the series. I want to see like what webtoon you think I've read.
Bro, I don't know. Okay, here, I found it. All I had to do was search up webtoon. Yeah, here you go, buddy. Do not put this on stream. But yeah, just read that for yourself, buddy. Go ahead and read. It's very little word.
I think literally never read this in my entire life.
No. Continue. Click through. You'll understand why I said
no. I was actually going to read it for a second. Oh my god.
No, don't read it out loud, idiot.
Oh
read it
my
in
god.
Your head.
Oh
read
my
it
god.
In your head. You dumbass. My god, bro. You're an actual special kind of idiot. You're a special kind of idiot. Listen, read in your head.
Oh,
all right?
What the fuck? What the fuck is this?
Cream score. Now, that's a very niche reference. Maybe you guys haven't seen it, right?
Mamma mia, dude. No! No! Dude, why does he look like Gojo too? Oh my god, I'm sick. I'm sick, no, bro.
Bro, sit. You said that's your goat? That's crazy. That's nuts.
Bro, you know, okay. This reminds me of, like, the Flash incident. I mean, it reminds me of nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Crazy.
I never even seen that movie.
Graham said Ezra Miller's a good person.
That is not what I fucking said. First of all, I never spoke about them. Second of all, I would never say that.
You never spoke about them?
Ever.
Okay.
Hypothetically speaking, did I send...
No. Don't back up on it now, buddy. You either own up to your falsities, right? Or Twitter's going to see your falsities, buddy. In fact, you have some... I'll just retweet your reply. I got you.
Oh, my God. Wait, just show me the reply real quick. Just like...
No, it's okay. Bro, you if you tweeted it, you got to hold that. I don't know what you want me to do with that. If you tweeted it, right? If you were cool with putting it out... That's on you, bro.
Okay.
That's just on you.
Okay, let's see. I'm going to go to your Twitter and then just keep refreshing the page until, like, my heart sinks.
All right, bro. I'll just wait until you're done doing that. Because it's not fun if you know it immediately. You just got to see it randomly on your timeline. You'll get it in a little bit. But, yeah. Let's see. A second dog and Beer's voltage ramps up. Meanwhile, the king of racism creams feels uneasy for the first time since the civil rights movement. Oh my god. Oh my Y'all god. Are Dude, concerningly good at this.
I hope you screenshot these because, like, when we do that. Oh, do you want to tell them the idea?
I'm taking note. No, you go ahead, buddy. Okay. It has nothing to do with you.
So BR had this idea for the 100th episode to screenshot a bunch of these, like, the funniest ones and put them in a tier list of his favorite cream slander jokes for the 100th. It's gonna be one of the things we do.
Yeah. Yep. Gonna be very, very, very fun. Yeah. Very fun. Appreciate you guys.
Yeah, so, you know, I hope that archive is very thin.
Oh, it's growing. It's growing, bro. It's growing.
That's not what I wanted to hear. Okay.
Yeah, no. Yeah, man. I mean, listen, I'm going to be real with you. This is the weakest episode if we're talking about pure JJK episode review. We have talked about this was a Baki episode, but let's be honest. Yeah. Let's be real. This was a Baki.
Yeah. I mean,
Creams, code red.
What?
Look, the chat, code red. Just letting you know.
I know Creams was out when he
Don't read it out loud, idiot. Read everything in your head. Very recent. If you need it to me, I'll send it to you.
Okay, I got it. So do you want to take the...
We just move. We just pivot. Okay. You know what I mean? Just pivot.
Okay. Hmm? So,
we had nothing to pivot to. That's actually kind of crazy.
Okay.
Wait. Chat, let me ask you guys this. If you were to rank this episode, right, out of every JJK episode of season 2 so far, what would it get on a scale of 1 to 10? And I'm also interested in what exactly is, like, your ranking so far. Has the Mechamaru fight ranked in anybody's top spot? Or is Hidden Inventory still kind of on top across the board for everybody? Mm. Just checking the pulse of you guys before we get into, like, really aggressive, really, like, hype content. Like, I'm sure next episode will probably be a lot of people's number one, right? But I'm kind of curious, like, before we get to some obvious picks like that, what you guys think?
Yeah. I'd also give it, like, a 7.
Yeah, it's getting, like, a 7.
Oh.
7, 6.5. Get you.
Okay. So I just want to pivot back to Baki for, like, 3 seconds, if you don't mind. So you know how in this episode Yuji was fighting the Grasshopper Curse?
Yeah.
I immediately thought about Baki doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And, like, despite Yuji technically having an easier time off-rip, there was something about Baki, like, overcoming and then becoming the Grasshopper and then going up his way through the Animal Kingdom all the way up to, like, Tyrannosaurus or, like, whatever dinosaur, Triceratops, where it was, like, why is it, right, in Baki, a show that ostensibly, or like a series that ostensibly has no power system, other people can see your, like, imagination. Because, like, bro, Pickle saw a Triceratops when Baki took a stance. Like, all he was doing was just leaning forward with his fist in front of his face, and he was like, that's a Triceratops.
Yeah. I mean, bro, listen, did you not see it?
Shut up. Oh my god. What you doing over there, man?
What do you mean?
You sort of chilling?
Yeah, no, I'm currently I'm just going through sorting the files from like most racist to least racist from you. There's a little bit of housekeeping.
That's insane. What's your metric?
Well, it's for you, it's amount of slur usage.
That is insane. That is an insane criteria.
I mean, you're the one that fits the bill. I don't know what you want me to do.
Why are you like this?
Interesting, because I'm black. What if I said that? What are you going to do about it? What are you going to say then? What if I said that? What are you going to say then? Nothing. Get quiet or lean into your racism. Which one? Silence, of course.
All right, guys.
Anywho.
I want to talk about something very near and dear to my heart. Never mind. I like did the calculus of the risk. It was way too much. I was not
gonna... good. No, please. We'd love to hear, like, please be vulnerable.
Be vulnerable. No. Let's not go crazy now. Okay. BR. I thought about your I don't even know what to call it. Nah, never mind. It's not interesting enough.
Okay. Fair enough. Fair enough.
Ooh, Landa, don't... Okay. You want to talk about reality TV? You know what? This is a members-only stream. You guys are very special. I want to thank you guys for, like, you know, being members, being here with me today on your time, and I value it so much. I want to share something with you that I don't really get a chance to talk about, like, in any other medium, right, that I have, any other platform, except for, like, anybody in my private life's inbox, including BR, who has unfortunately heard a whole sermon about this, and, of course, Landa. Okay, so I have been rewatching The Jersey Shore, right, from, like, the original run of the show, from episode one, because I rewatched it a couple times when I was younger, and I wanted to get back into it as, like, an adult, right? And I wanted to also get into Family Vacation with, like, the full context of where everybody ended off, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, when I tell you, watching this show with an adult perspective is one of the craziest experiences I've had rewatching something in my entire life, I mean it, all right? Because one of the biggest things I have realized is that there is this ludonarrative dissonance between the show, the reality the show exists in, and the reality the show is experienced in. So what I mean by this is within the Jersey Shore context, right? Like within the confines of the show's like narrative, like every episode, like week to week, the show of Jersey Shore does not exist, right? It is nothing. It is not a thing that is acknowledged. Like its presence is very heavily suppressed, edited around. Like it's supposed to feel almost fly on the wall to like an insane degree. Like you are God watching these people week to week, right? That's mm-hmm. like the language of that show. However, as the show got more and more popular season by season, one of the challenges the producers had was hiding the popularity, and these people are now, like, they started off as, like, regular people, but after, like, the first or second season became worldwide celebrities on a massive level, right? But they still had to, like, do the premise of the show, which was, you know, these average people partying. But by seasons, like, three or four, these people were, like, millionaires, right, from this fucking show. And, like, they were, like, doing brands, blah, 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 right? And the way this manifests is it hit this, like, fever pitch in season five, I think it was, where they were having, like, a usual Jersey Shore confrontation, right? They were going at each other, like fucking screaming, like, usual Jersey Shore fight that they have, like, week to week, right? And let me tell you guys, the funniest thing was that they decided to do this outside on, like, a balcony. And there was such a crowd outside this balcony screaming, going off into this massive chant at one point, that the editors, the Jersey Shore editors, God bless each and every single one of them, tried their fucking hardest, but could not edit out the chanting and the screaming, that in the midst of, like, this very heated, very real argument between the Shoremates, all you could hear was people being like, "We love the Jersey Shore! Oh my god!" And it was so funny, because you can't edit that around. It's a whole chant of people in close proximity to the event happening. Imagine if you were having, like, a serious argument with your parents or, like, your loved ones, right? And outside, like, within earshot, like, of an open window, is somebody screaming, "We love you guys!" It is so funny, and you can't acknowledge it. They cannot acknowledge that this is happening, because it would almost break the immersion the show is setting forth. And it is... It's like a small microcosm of a larger thing that keeps happening, but it's something that, like, I have just been losing my mind over trying to like discuss in some way, shape, or form. And I appreciate you guys indulging me for these few minutes. There is way more. I might make a video on this, like just to exercise the demon fully when I'm fully caught up to family vacation. But that is where I'm at now. I appreciate you so much for your time. Thank you.
You're welcome. And yeah, chat, on, do you want to tell them about your other, like, some of the beef you have maybe with the show?
That's
the people that make
it. I don't have another hour. I think it's season 5.
Whoa, that's crazy. That's nuts.
Prince Maniac, I think it's season 5, episode 7? Or season 5, episode 8, from what I remember.
Interesting. Yeah, I mean, I guess the more you know, chat, like, add it to the Cream's iceberg. He's a very big Jersey Shore fan. Although, there's a caveat to that. But yeah. Yep. I'm glad you're able to get that off your chest, man.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I feel like I exercised, like, a massive demon, man.
That's nice.
It is nice. I'm like plotting. I'm like counting down the days until you, like, start watching it, so, you know, you and I can really go at it.
Yeah, bro. So I won't have some of your bigoted views, but, like, outside of that, I think we can probably have a nice discussion for sure. For sure. But yeah, I don't know if you have anything else. I feel like we really went east to west.
Yeah,
on this conversation,
yeah,
bro.
With some JJK in the middle.
Yeah, that was a journey.
You know, this is going to be a fun-ass idea for the 100th. I'm just going to write, like, a list of things that I have, like, absolutely no reason to talk about and just, like, spend... I think that's going to be, like, when you go, like, on your bathroom break or whatever for the 100th. I'm just going to take that time to, like, vent about a lot of stuff that I just, like, have no other place or context to say them in. So the Jersey Shore one is, like, top of the list, obviously. But I also want to talk about, like, some other minor stuff. Yeah, I'm gonna write that down. Yeah. That's a good one. You should start planning for your intermission speech. Sermon.
Bro.
Sorry.
There are only two characters I can imagine myself talking about. Maybe three if I'm feeling a little bit, energetic that day. It's Percy Jackson and it's Sasuke. Maybe I can throw Lelouch in there, depending on how tyrannical I'm feeling. But yeah, I already have it planned out, bro. That was going to be crazy. Let's just say I always have some dialogue on standby for goats, you know what I mean?
Of course, naturally.
Yeah. As long as you have, like, extra time. But yeah, yep. I guess the episode is, episode 100 is getting closer and closer, so I guess you guys can look forward to that.
Wow, Hansel Grotto, that is insane. What?
Let's see. The problem. Whoa.
Nah, that's
crazy. Whoa. That's crazy. That's nuts. And getting screenshotted. Appreciate adding yourself to the committee. Thank you.
Yeah, can you give me like a loose ballpark of the number we're at right now?
For specifically chats. Cooking of you?
Chats, comments, you know, the whatever's going on that list.
We're about 30.
30?
Not too much, but what?
30?
Not too much yet, but we're working on it.
Oh, God.
you're a little bit ignorant to think that this started like with, you know what I mean? Like, you think this is before you, buddy. I was recording this for my own personal enjoyment before this was like a game or like a segment, bro. You know what I mean? And now I've just supercharged it a little bit. I've just decided to give them a little bit of a reason to go harder, if you will. Does that make me such a bad guy? I don't think so, personally. I really don't think so.
God.
I think before the 100th episode, we can get to at least 100. I'm confident that we can. I really think we can.
You gonna reinforce the bounty next episode? Like on Sunday?
Yeah, I might bring it up. It depends. If you guys want to slander Megumi or whatever, like I might ban a couple of people, and then like remember, you're like, hey guys, you know, if you don't want to be banned.
No, what I think they should do is if they've never said anything about Megumi, but they still came up with a fire one, we should give them like a gifted pardon.
No, not happening. What? Because that encourages you to slander Megumi, and that's not what I'm doing here.
That's wild.
Yeah. By the way, once you, here's the thing. Listen. This is a little bit of a sneak peek, a little bit of some insider trading information, right? Once I pardon you from all of your crimes, if you decide to add to them, you're done right on the spot. I'm not waiting. Now, the general public doesn't know this yet, right? So for all you guys that are in here right now, people that like to slander Megumi, first of all, I'm watching you literally right now. You know what I mean? And second of all, count your days, all right? Count your days. Yuichi from Tomodachi Game. Yuichi, cool. I could talk about Yuichi for a while. There are a lot of main characters I could talk about for hours on end. But, like, Kareem's is so... He's such, like, a manga baby. Like...
It's a crazy way to
Bro's not really read all that much, you know what I mean? We're not the same. Like, keep in mind, Chad, a little bit ago, his top 10 manga, like, included Black Clover. You know what I mean? Like...
You know, yeah, it's like... You know what's funny? I was thinking about this, right? I lost my train of thought. Whoa, like that hit me out of nowhere. Completely
you losing your train of thought.
Oh yeah. The Speaking horror. Of me being a manga newbie or like an anime newbie, started watching Cowboy Bebop for the first time this week. It's been neat.
Did you?
Yeah, I'm like 7 episodes in.
That's sick.
Yeah. It's cool. My friend who's showing it to me, right, he didn't know about like how he didn't even know the live action was like a thing, let alone like it being bad. He was like, can you paint me a picture for how bad it was? And I was like trying to rack my brain around it. I was like, what can I say to him that would like get the message across? And then I remembered, you know that line about blackmail?
I did not watch live action, bro.
It went like crazy on Twitter.
So
I sent him that one, and I was like, okay, it was basically like this.
Said that he threw up like just right where he stood,
basically. Yeah,
gotcha. That's unfortunate, but you know, good to know. He like, first of all, I personally would have let him live in ignorance. I'm not gonna lie, I would never have even told him that, but yeah,
I just think it's funny for him to know that.
Wait, funny, scarring, kind of, yeah, one or the other.
Creed needs his own segment, reading segment for members, only streams for reals. I appreciate that, Spirit. Appreciate you. Let's catch up, bro. I don't know. I think I got to take back one of the appreciate yous. Like, you could have just left it there. Anyway, I think that's it for this episode, unless you have anything else, BR?
Nope. Pretty chill.
We will see you guys on Sunday.
Yeah. See you guys later.
Yeah. Bye.
Liv's going to be on the stream. She wasn't really able to be here today, but Sunday will be really fun. So show up.
Yeah. Know.